Hi everyone, this is Veronica and today we are going to talk about a very important topic, that is honey can be used as a biomarker for pollution. So this is a very important topic. As you know, recently the Geo19 report, Global Environment Outlook report 2019 has also come, and there everywhere it has been stated that pollution is a major crisis, future crisis and the present crisis. So here a study reveals that honey can be used as a biomarker. Now we'll discuss in detail what is a biomarker. There are other terms also like biomonitor, bioindicator. So what are they, how it can be used as biomarker, we will discuss in detail. For my video updates, you can follow me in Instagram and on Facebook. This is a channel, StudyIQ. If you're preparing for any government exam, our pen drive and tablet courses are also available. For additional information, you can call on these numbers or you can visit our website too. The PDF of this lecture will be available on our website in both the languages, Hindi and English. And here you can take the screenshot of the courses that we have in our pen drive and tablet courses, right? So now what is that relevance of this topic from exam point of view? See, if we talk from the UPSC perspective, it will be covered under mains paper 3 environment. Here it will be covered. At objective level, you should know these terms, what are biomarkers, bioindicators, biomonitors. So see, whenever there's a term bio included with anything, so mostly it relates to the living things only, right? So if you're using a marker, it won't be a non-living thing, it would be a living thing. So that is how it goes for the bioindicators and biomonitors too. And at subjective level, utility of biomarkers in pollution assessment, what is that, you should know. Now let's come to the topic. Here it is written that honey, which could be collected from urban areas, as it was collected from the urban areas, it can be used as biomarker. And why it is can be used as biomarker? So that it can help us to identify the polluted localities. So this is said by a study which was conducted by Pacific Center of Isotopic and Geochemical Research, PCIGR, that is in University of Columbia, British Columbia, that is in Vancouver, Canada, right? So this is the news. Now let's come to the biomarker word. See, thousands of pollutants enter daily into environment and exert various kinds of stress on organisms and ecosystems. Now risk assessment of these pollutants to organisms and ecosystem is challenging because of the diversities in chemical nature and the mode of toxicity of these pollutants, as well as variation in the sensitivities of the organisms which are exposed to these pollutants. Now understand this, that even low concentrations of pollutants often produce deleterious effects on organisms, which are difficult to be predicted because a measurable effects are expressed only after prolonged exposure. But we cannot wait until a prolonged exposure because we cannot revert the condition then back to the normal. So it may be too late to take remedial actions or steps to reduce the risk when these incipient effects are expressed. Therefore, it is necessary to develop an early warning system or signals, or we call them biomarkers. Now you understand what is in layman language, what are biomarkers? These are the early warning system signals, which are known as biomarkers, that convincingly reflect adverse biological responses towards anthropogenic environmental toxins. What are anthropogenic environmental toxins? These are the man-made toxins which are there in the environment because of the man's activity, human activity, right? Even at minute concentration. So let me define a biomarker for you. A biomarker is defined as a change in biological response ranging from molecular to cellular, or a physiological response to behavior changes also, which can be related to exposure to or toxic effects of environmental chemicals. Now you should know this definition of biomarker. Now see, recent developments in molecular biology and biotechnology and inventions of sophisticated instruments, they have led to a development of novel, more sensitive, validated biomarkers of exposure effect also. But we use living organisms and such products of living things as biomarkers also, and honey being one of them in the latest studies. Now just see how honey can be used as biomarker. These honey samples were analyzed for the study. They were collected from 6 different geographical areas, right? And these areas within the Vancouver is a place in Canada. So these were included from different geographical areas. Their urban areas were included, then your industrial areas, samples were taken from all these areas, residential areas, then your agricultural areas also. Right. Now, from these samples, the scientists tested for 3 major elements, and these elements were lead, zinc, and copper. Now, the results showed that areas with heavy vehicle movement and industrial activity, it had increased concentration of lead in honey. And on the other hand, the samples from the agriculture area, it indicated high levels of manganese, right? Which researchers suspect could be because of pesticide use. Since honeybee collects nectar from within a range of 3 to 4 kilometers, it is easy to point the source for its contamination. Now see, all these scientific studies, they are not just done like that. They use a control also. Like in case of honey, they used a lead control also. They took lead from the natural resources around the Vancouver to rule out that this lead in the honey isn't from the natural source. But the lead they found in the honey and the natural lead, there were a lot of differences. So it ruled out the possibility that the contamination was because from the natural sources, rather it was from the sources of vehicular movement and the industrial activity. And same is the case with the manganese, which was obtained from the samples from the agricultural area. Right. Now, see, there are some other biomarkers also. Similarly, another study of the aquatic plant called the hyacinth. Here you can see in the picture. So, hyacinth, its scientific name is Echornea crassipes. You can pronounce them as you like. Right. So, this is a scientific name. So, it is found that these can be used as biomarkers too. And this plant is commonly found in the tropical countries and is known for its ability to absorb nutrients and other elements from the water. Now, the stems and leaves have been successfully used as indicators of heavy metal pollution in tropical countries. And the uptake of heavy metals in this plant is stronger in roots than in the floating shoots, states the study. Now we'll talk here about few other terms also. As I told you, what are bioindicators? See, bioindicator is any species or a group of species whose function, population, or status can reveal the qualitative status of the environment, right? And another term is biological monitor or a bio monitor. Okay, and see, biomonitor is an organism that provides quantitative information on the quality of environment around it. Therefore, a good biomonitor will indicate the presence of pollutant and also attempt to provide additional information about the amount and intensity of exposure also. And like that, water hyacinth can be included as a bioindicator also. Although these can be used interchangeably, these words. So if in prelims a question is asked in bioindicator, biomonitor or biomarker, you should not get confused. So this is about today's lecture. If you have any queries, you can contact me on social media. Thank you.